Yeah, yeah, I know what you're thinking. You can get a job in the Middle East simply by trying or by magic through others or by a fluke. Remember that competition is everywhere. Some here, some there, but bam, Loy Macedo is the best.
Speaking to you from LoyMacedo.com. Who's Loy Macedo and Think Personal Branding? All right, a couple of housekeeping announcements before we start. If you want to send me any confidential information with regards to the UAE or the Middle East, or you just want to bitch and moan and cry about things, send it to me via my email is put down below. WhatsApp also is put down. If you want to support the channel and support my work, my PayPal details are put down, or you can send the money in bank transfer or by PayPal, or sorry, Western Union. And for those of you who are looking for jobs, just send me your email with your updated resume on the subject line. That is the important part. The subject line, put the title of the job, like sales, engineering, whatever. Be specific. Put a nice covering letter. Don't overly do it. And whatever you send me, I'll send it forwarded to the right people who are asking. You don't have to pay anything. Please don't pay me anything. Don't send me any money. If the employer asks me, can you send me a sales CV? And I sort out based on sales. I'll forward them your details, okay? And make sure that in that letter, you also mention what is the take it or leave it salary. Take it or leave it means $1 below that salary, you're not interested in the job. So give them your best salary. So don't put like, I'm looking at 15,000, but it's negotiable to 5,000. So please use common sense, okay? Okay, let's move on. These are the updates that are given to me. Why are people who are in the Middle East, it's not mentioned in the newspaper. Where it's mentioned in the newspaper, I'll share the links down below. Okay, so this is what is said to me. My contact who's working in the Ministry Commerce, what he has told me, the good news is 100,000 new jobs are going to come up in the UAE, 100,000. So I was like, from where the hell is 100,000 new jobs? The thing is, the UAE government is working very hard to revive the economy. They can't sit, just sit with their legs crossed and say, no, nothing is happening. There's a COVID. No, they are putting really a lot of effort to make the economy run, which is where new projects are coming up. They will make sure that people are working, whether it's projects, whether it's events, whether it is whatever, even sporting events, it seems are going to be coming up. So they are looking out for people to actually work. Okay. So 100,000 new jobs will be created. Along with that, it seems new protocols will be put in place. A lot of testing will be done. They'll make sure that you are not sick, in some cases, they're even saying that where you work, you'll be staying in the company quarters. You'll not be allowed to go out, interaction and all that. So strict protocols are being put in place. Very important is the salary letter is being revised. Okay. So in many cases, it's like a person was working in one department of one company. A new job offer will be given, but obviously because of the cost factor, they are going to cut down your salary. So that's kind of good news, 100,000 new jobs. But on the flip side, the bad news is 130,000 jobs are going to be cut off in the next 2-3 months. Okay, 130,000 jobs. And the reason for this is there is still, no business. Most of the decisions that were taken were based on the economy is going to improve. Projects are going to come. Expo 2020 is going to happen. So with all these future anticipation, they did a lot of things. And that is, obviously it's not going to happen. So people who are going to lose their jobs are primarily from the restaurant industry. Plenty of restaurants. I spoke to one guy yesterday night, a group of restaurants, large ones. He said revenues are down by 60%. Okay. They can't survive on deliveries alone. Gyms are being badly affected. Restaurants, I've told you, retail outlets also are not seeing too much of sales. Most of the people are being asked to do 2-3 people's jobs, and many of them are being terminated. I spoke to a couple of airline and tourism people. It seems that after the terminations are taking place, people have to do 2-3 people's jobs. Let's say, for example, a customer service has to also do the baggage handler's job, has to also do the customer service, pick and drop. And like even in supermarkets, before they used to have the staff that used to only do the customer service. Now they have to do deliveries. Now they have to do, different other tasks. Now, in a way, it's kind of good because it teaches you multiplicity of skills. But in a way, it's also bad because you're doing 2-3 people's jobs. But it's better to have a job than not have a job. Malls, it seems, have cut down its rates because they don't want malls to be empty. They want retail outlets to remain. Luxury, to my surprise, luxury brands are still selling. Okay, luxury, that means, which I told you before, people have the money. It's not that money has all vanished. Rich people are still rich. They are really doing well. In fact, I read one article. I don't know. You can Google search this. Jeff Bezos made $10 billion or something in one day or something like that. Online and e-commerce businesses are all up. I spoke to a couple of my friends who are actually having their online business. They seem to be doing pretty well. They said that, now that things are resumed, only some of them are having problems with regards to deliveries because in some countries, it is still, the protocol is pretty tight. My friend who's getting stuff from China and then he's rebranding this and selling it, he's finding different ways and means to how he can bypass. Only thing is, there is a delay, okay? Retail, these are some of the stats that were given to me. You can check it via Reuters, you can check it via LinkedIn, you can check it via different other websites. So this is specifically to UAE and the Middle East, okay? Retail is down by 63%. Universities and schools have taken a hammering, especially in the UAE. Recreation and travel vacancies are down by 82%. Media and communication business are down by 30%. It seems even advertising revenues are down. Construction industry very badly hit, 45% down. Technology software jobs have increased by 66%. Don't ask me how did they come with these numbers. This is what was given to me. This is what I'm telling you. Healthcare business has increased by 28%. So more people are sick. But what I suspect over there is they are charging you more money for more tests. And people, when they're scared, obviously they pay money. Non-oil private sector has been down from the last 15 months. I think it's much more than that. There have been plenty of arrests. There have been plenty of people who have not paid their loans and credit cards. They are into serious trouble. I've told you this before. I've told you before, don't take a loan, don't take a card. And if you're taking it, then you'll have to pay. Now it seems one of the options that are being offered is if you have taken a amount of money and you cannot pay, either you are put behind bars, and if you're put in jail and you not pay the money and you're put in jail, you'll be there for a period of 1 month or whatever. And then after that, the null and void, whatever the difference that you pay. But the drawback to this is you are going to be blacklisted. You'll have a permanent black mark on your credit ratings. And on top of that, if you do think of traveling abroad, I don't think that's going to happen for quite some time. Also, for the people who are thinking of migrating to Canada, US, and all those countries, it seems it's opening up. But don't expect when you go there, they're going to welcome you with open arms. Canada is offering you like $2,000 every month, unemployment benefits. But this is not sustainable because the government will collapse. If they keep giving out money, the government will collapse. And when it collapses, the country collapses. And if the country collapses, they're not going to give you any benefits. And then you're going to be unemployed. So it is just a very short-term solution, but it breeds bad habits that are permanent. I wouldn't be comfortable getting a salary for sitting at home. So don't be so comfortable. Don't be so happy, especially for the Canadians. I'll tell you, be very careful because you're getting used to a very easy lifestyle and there is a price to pay for this. Okay. Second wave of terminations is coming following August. Get prepared for it. August and September. I cannot give you the names of the companies, but my contacts at the, whether you believe or don't believe, these guys have told me the second wave of terminations already there. And some companies have already prepared the list one by one. You'll be finding out from your friends. You can find out if what I'm saying is true or false. Emirates and Danata, it's a wipeout. They are terminating still. I also found out from my friend who's in the immigration, it seems that those who are out of the country for more than 6 months, before they were being very generous, no, don't worry, you can come back. But now it seems if you're out of the country for 6 months, your visa is automatically by default expired. You'll have to reapply. Now, what are the hidden charges? What are the extra charges? What are the fines? That I'm not aware of, but it seems that your visa will be expired. You'll have to reapply once again. And when you reapply, obviously, you'll have to pay money. So there is no benefits. Okay. I have a couple of names of big businessmen who are in UAE. It seems they made a couple of deals and they're not able to pay those deals because of which now they are in trouble. I don't want to take the names because their names were not mentioned in the papers, but it seems that they are either in jail or they're going to be in trouble, or their property is going to be, or their wealth is going to be seized by big, powerful, not banks, but locals. So a couple of big names, businessmen who have money to pay and they have not paid, no excuse for them. Okay. Event management companies are not paying back the money for those who booked their wedding in advance or booked any event or conference or seminar. It seems you're not getting your money in advance. And please be careful if you're going to put any feedback or negative reviews. These people, they don't take very kindly to a negative review on the website. Okay. A couple of news that I've received is Oman declares a full lockdown from 25th of July. So full lockdown, please. If you are planning to get out of the country, you'll not be called back in. And if you are in the country, you'll not be allowed to leave. So just keep this in mind. GulfInsider.com reports this. And for those people who, you know, keep saying that UAE is going to be in trouble, US is going to destroy. Well, let me just tell you that it seems that Donald Trump is discussing with Abu Dhabi ways and means of how to improve their relationships, because UAE is very generous and supporting Donald Trump in his next election bid. So you can be rest assured, UAE is in the good books of USA. Nothing is going to happen to UAE. Nothing is going to happen. So UAE knows, UAE is not dumb. UAE knows whom to make friendship with. So whatever news that you tend to see, like for example, this one, US sanctions, 5 UAE companies for oil, petrochemical deals with Iran. And it gave the list of 5 companies here. It seems that Petrogrand, FZE, Alphabet International, DMCC, Swissol Trade, DMCC, Alam, Al Tharwa General Trading, and Alvino LLC. This was given by spglobal.com. Even though this is happening, this is, remember this, in the United States, there are 2 political parties. There is the left and there is the right. So even if one side is against you, the other side makes friends with you. And Donald Trump is the president. He is being supported by UAE. So as long as that is there, nothing is going to happen. Qatar Airways, on the other hand, well, congratulations. You have won the court case. It seems that it is seeking $5 billion in compensation from the Arab bloc over the airspace ban. All the best to Qatar. I don't think you're going to get this. And Qatar is also getting completely hardcore to make sure that it takes over with Qatar Airways and gets back to Emirates Airlines. Emirates Airlines is really, really going through a lot of shit right now. They have, it seems that most of their aircrafts are filled with the cargo stuff. They have 130 A380s, and those are completely a wipeout. So UAE is bleeding over, the hemorrhaging there. And for those Indians who are very happy to go back to their country, well, what I found out from the Indians who are going back, once you're back to your country, it seems because you're from UAE, they think you have a lot of money. They keep you in quarantine. And once you're in quarantine, you need to pay the hotel big, big sums of money, which the Indian government is not going to shoulder. So once you go back to India, it seems you'll have to stay in a nice hotel and you'll have to pay a lot of money for staying in the 5-star hotel or whatever they ask you to pay. So it's not actually a honeymoon phase for you. And for the Indians, Pakistanis, and, you know, whomsoever, Filipinos or Sri Lankans who have gone back, it doesn't seem to be very good. They are finding it very tough. India is going through hell where it seems the COVID virus is spreading. It's a complete chaos. Pakistanis, they are trying to get back to normal, but I don't have much information then. If you do, let me know. I received a couple of videos of migrant workers who are selling stuff to make ends meet. They have not been paid for 3 to 6 months. They shared with me the video, but I'll not share it because the faces are very visible. You know, they're just doing whatever they can to survive. So I would just say, if you are passing by, instead of taking a video, buy something from them so at least they can survive and sustain with a little bit of profit. Please don't negotiate with them. Support them. Support these poor fellows until they go back. And Fenabler, it seems that B.R. Shetty's company has appointed this company, Skadden, to investigate the potential misconduct. B.R. Shetty, as far as I see, is more or less over. It's better he just retires and enjoys the last final years of his life. And last and not the least, I just want to say that to all those people who are very angry with me in terms of Sheikh Mohammed's the same video that I put up, some of them told me he's alive and doing well. I'm very happy. Like I told you, I admire the guy. I want him to live. Some other people are saying, no, it's a fake name. No, it's not a fake person who is dressed up like him. It is actually Sheikh Mohammed, as far as I know. You're watching too many Hollywood movies. And last but not the least, with regards to Rather Sterling, I put up the video where I said I was supporting her. And then I put up the other video where I spoke about, you know, this David Hague versus Rather Sterling. So it seems both the parties, their fans, have started to bombard me with, you know, you're a sellout. You know, David Hague's people are saying that Rather Sterling is fake. Rather Sterling's camp is saying David Hague is like, listen, whomsoever is fake, whomsoever is real, I wish you both all the best. I don't have anything against you. I don't have anything, you know. Do good. Just do good for other people and help people succeed. And for those people who keep saying, no, UAE should be destroyed. Once again, I tell you, UAE shouldn't be destroyed. Nobody benefits by UAE being destroyed. I wish UAE all the best. It's just that UAE is focusing on the Mars, going to Mars and all that, instead of focusing on, you know, investing in its people. So this is what I've received. Please, once again, I'm telling you, there are jobs. This is a couple of tips for you. Abu Dhabi is aggressively looking out for people. If you're qualified, if you have your documents in place, Abu Dhabi is giving you a job. Dubai, the companies that I found out is, they are keeping you on probation. They're not giving you actually the visa, but most of the people have, like, they resign from the company and the company gives them a buffer. So they are working on someone else's visa or they're taking a free zone visa. Sharjah, it seems people are working from, you know, the old visa or purchased visa. So whatever works for you, do well. If you are in UAE for all these years, do not leave the country just yet. It's not paradise if you go back home. Stick around. You know, the economy is improving, like I told you. There are jobs coming up. If you want to find out the jobs, check in Gulf News, Khaleej Times, National Paper, because that is the reliable place. Beware. Be very careful of what is appearing on Doobizzle. I've got people who told me they applied to Doobizzle. These LinkedIn and these Gulf Talent and Naukri is all bullshit and Monster. It's all fake jobs. Don't even bother applying through them because, and if anybody, you know, if something is too good to be true and they guarantee you a job and, you know, they keep your hopes up, chances are after making your hopes go up, confirming everything, they're going to ask you processing fee. So that is a fake. So please be careful of that. So these are the headlines that I wanted to share with you. Let me know your thoughts. And this is me signing off for now. Take care. I got a lot of work. There are people who are, you know, actually getting jobs. So like I told you, the economy is getting better. Let's hit it big time. Let's be positive and let's hope for the best. Keep me updated. Any information, this is me signing off. Take care.
Are you fed up of life? Earning a pathetic salary, working long hours, having an ungrateful boss, facing office politics, the constant fear of losing your job, and after paying rent, groceries, shopping, and children's expenses, you are left with hardly any savings. Is this the life you dreamed of? Or do you wish to change your life forever? Meet Loy Macedo, the world's number one personal branding coach. He will help you identify the real you. Position and sell yourself by getting the job of your dreams and make good money anywhere in the world. If you do not believe me, Google his name, Loy Macedo, and you will find 2 million web links online and over 200 recommendations from very happy clients. So the question is, do you want to change your life? If yes, then contact Loy Macedo. www.loymacedo.com. Who is loymacedo.com? ThinkPersonalBranding.com. What are you waiting for? Do it now.